we know that we couldn't make it without you. Oh God, we couldn't even walk without you holding our hand. Oh God, we couldn't even breathe if you didn't breathe into us first. So Father, we thank you for that we have our being, oh God, through you, oh God. Thank you, oh God, for all that you do for us, even the things that we don't even recognize, oh God. We thank you for those things. We thank you for protecting us, oh God, from danger seen and unseen. Oh God, we come to magnify your name. We come to glorify your name, oh God. We come to put ourselves on the shelf and lift you up, oh God. For it's about you today. It's about you every day, oh God. We pray, oh God, that we will not forget that, oh God. That we will seek you first and your righteousness, oh Father, that you would add all the things that we need unto us, oh God. Thank you, oh God, that there may be some under the sound of my voice who need a comforting word today. Some under my voice may need an encouraging word today, oh God. Oh God, some of us need direction, oh God, and we come to you, oh God, seeking that direction, oh God. Help us, oh God, in our greatest need, oh God, we pray. Oh Father, we pray for our pastor, oh God, Michael A. Pope Sr., pray for his wife, Mary Pope. Oh God, we pray for all our ministerial staff and all of our missions here at the church. Oh God, we pray for our membership. Oh God, be with us, oh God, as we stand with you through it all. Oh God, we're going to make it through. Thank you. And in Jesus' name we pray and ask these things in your Son, Jesus Christ's name. Amen and thank God. Amen. Amen. It's always good to be in the service of the Lord. Amen. It also picks you up. Amen. We pray that the song that will be sung and the word that will be brought forth will lift up your spirits today. That's what I expect for myself, so I expect that for you as well. Amen. Amen. And we're going to ask Brother Jerry Sherrod and Brother Lynn Smith if they would bless us in song. Amen. And then we will follow the order of service as we do here at St. Paul. Thank you. Amen.
Say good morning and praise God from whom all blessings flow.
Amen.
Give God all glory, all honor, and all praise. We're just glad to see you, the brethren in the house. Again, this morning, see how good it is for brethren to dwell together in the house of the Lord. And we want to reach out to our sick and shut in this morning and wish them a speedy recovery. Brother Sonny Smith, we hope you're listening and know that we love you, we miss you.
meditate on is to delight myself in the Lord, and that he would give me the desires of my heart. So I just thank God again for his word, and that this scripture, if it touched your heart, please join us on Wednesday night for our Bible study, that you may, that we may go even deeper into this scripture. So we're going to have a song from our Brother Lynn Smith and Brother Jerry Sherrod, and then we're going to come back in the order of our service. Amen.
Lord, prepare for your sanctuary.
Sanctuary,
more than holy.
space here today, and as I have given a testimony some months back, there's a war going on. There's a spiritual war going on. And I recognize that fact and know that I need to have my full armor on. Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. So we pray that you have your full armor on, and as Pastor had preached a couple of Sundays ago, that your oil may be filled. Amen. Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
That you may be ready when he comes. So we just thank God for our pastor today, and we look forward to his word today, and we pray that you would have an ear to hear. So the next voice you would hear would be from our pastor, amen. We pray that you will give him plenty of amens over the Facebook lines and even here in the sanctuary, amen. So from our pastor, amen.
Thank you, Brother Chairman. Hear now the word of God. And he called the multitude and said unto them, hear and understand, not that which goeth into the mouth defileth a man, but that which cometh out of the mouth that defileth a man. Mm. Then came his disciples.
Wow.
And said unto him, knowest thou that the Pharisees were offended after they heard this saying? Mm. But he answered and said, every plant which my heavenly Father hath not planted shall be rooted up. Let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind.
Oh, yes.
And if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into the ditch. Mm-hmm. Then answered Peter and said unto him, declare unto us this parable. And Jesus said, are ye also yet without understanding? Do not yet understand that whosoever entereth, that whatsoever entereth in at the mouth goeth into the belly and is cast out into the drought. But those things which proceed out of the mouth come forth from the heart, they defile the man. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murderers, adulterers, fornicators, thefts, false witness, blasphemies. These are the things which defile a man. But to eat with unwashed hands defileth not. Amen.
All right.
Amen. And just for a little while this morning, I want to share a topic, polluted lives. Polluted lives. Here in our Lord's Gospel, according to Matthew, Savior, a delegation had come from Jerusalem. They had come charging the disciples with uncleanliness. They had charged them with uncleanliness for eating with their hands unclean. Eating with their hands unwashed. And so it was a violation of the tradition of the elders. Please understand that this was a ceremonial matter. It was very ritualistic that went back to the Old Testament, where different things could determine you to be unclean. This was an elaborate hand-washing ritual. And please understand that it was an oral code where the Pharisees had placed their own views above the Word of God. And I just came by this morning to say to us, a good indication of us leading a polluted life is when we allow our own views to be above the Word of God. Please know that Jesus had rejected this oral code. He had rejected man-made traditions of the scribes and of the Pharisees because they focused on the outside and ignored the inner person. And please understand that many a person from the outside may look like they have it all together, but deep down and on the inside, they're bitter and they have evil thoughts in their hearts. Here, the heart is more than the organ that pumps blood. It's more than that. But here, the heart is the inner self. It is the inner self that thinks, feels, and decides. The heart often means someone's true character or personality. And how many of us know that God knows the heart of every person? No, not just some people, but God knows the heart of each and every one of us. For the Word of God says, for the Lord seeth not as man seeth. Why? Because man looketh on the outward appearance. No, man looks on the outside, but the Lord looketh on the heart. Since a person acts and speaks from his heart, he or she is to guard it well. Now the Word says, keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. And sometimes in life, all we have So many have gotten off the garden path because we've got issues. We've got issues with our character.
Well,
we've got issues with our personality.
My Lord.
And we've gotten off the garden path. No, listen, I just came by to tell us on today, if you have a polluted life, you need to understand that character matters.
All right.
Yes. Godly morals matter. Personality matters. No, if it didn't matter, then Jesus would not have exemplified him while he was here on the earth. No, while the Savior was here on the earth, he was loving. He was kind. He was forgiving. He looked on the multitude with compassion. No, how many of us know that the truth of the matter is that we can honor God with our lips, but our hearts can be far from him?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Maybe that's why Jesus teaches that the part of the individual that matters is the heart.
Yeah. Mm.
Let me get right to the heart of the matter. Oh, he teaches us in the Beatitudes that blessed are the poor in heart, for they will see God. And so the real question is, do you want to see God?
All right.
And if you want to see God, then we need to ask ourselves, what is the state of our heart? Are we leading a polluted life? You know if you're leading a polluted life. If you're leading a polluted life, you have gotten off track. And you have gotten away from the word of God that you can pay lip service to serving the Lord, but be far away from him.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Real question. Do you want to see God? If you want to see God, then you need to ask yourself, what is the state of my heart? Listen, we can only say good when our hearts are pure. That being the case, then the proper response for everybody in here and for everybody on Facebook Live is that God have mercy upon me, a sinner.
Yes, yes, sir.
But there is some good news, for God can change the heart.
Yes.
Anybody know that God can change the heart? How do you know he can change your heart? Yes. Listen, he changed my heart. He changed your heart. He can change the heart. He can make us clean on the inside. David said, oh Lord, grant to me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me. For only God can change the heart. And I came by to remind you this morning that God can change your heart.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. That's right.
All across this country.
Yeah.
We are in need of a godly change.
Yes.
We need a godly change because so much of the inner self is polluted.
Well,
we have become defiled. We have become defiled by the unloving words that spring so readily taught that lesson. The disciples came to him and shared. They said, Lord, your teaching, it had offended the Pharisees. And how many of us know that we live in a time, especially if you're standing on the word of God, we live in a time where people are so easily offended by the word of God. So easily offended. I mean, people who even claim to be Christians and believers in the word of God are so easily offended just by the word of God. Is there anybody here that knows what I'm talking about? So easily offended. One of the reasons is that we have given higher priority to the traditions of man. You understand? This is the way that we've always have done it. That's tradition. Many have given higher priority to the traditions of man. And many have given higher priority to the way of the world. And many have given higher priority to a twisted culture. Listen, we may no longer be troubled by disputes over food and purity laws and hand washing before meals, but yet we still find ways to quarrel with one another. Yes.
My Lord.
You try talking politics with somebody on today.
Oh, yeah.
That's going to be a quarrel.
Oh, yeah.
You try discussing different practices based on the word of God. That's going to be a quarrel. You start discussing religious beliefs and why you believe the way you do and why you live the way that you do. That's going to be a quarrel.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
We quarrel with one another over differences of practices, over different political beliefs. And I'm so afraid on today that so many are headed for the ditch.
Yeah.
Is there anybody here that knows what I'm talking about? So many are headed for the ditch. Jesus pointed out that the Pharisees, they were blind, and that they could only lead their converts into the ditch. He called them blind guides, and that they could not see where they were going. Even on today, so many are willing to follow blind guides. Blind guides that will only lead them into the ditch. Blind guides that embrace conspiracy theories. Blind guides that lead them contrary to the word of God. Blind guides that have no morals, no values based on the word of God. Blind guides that will only lead them to the ditch. All because they refuse to follow the word of God. But Jesus said something that was profound. This is what he said. He said, let them alone. Let them alone. They were blind to God's they're blind to the truth. They can't handle the truth. No matter how many times you give them the truth, they're going to spin the truth to have to say what they want to say instead of what the Word of God is saying. To that, Jesus says, let them alone. Let them alone. Anyone who would listen to their teaching, they're risking spiritual blindness. Not even all religious leaders clearly see God's truth. And so, if you don't want to live a polluted life, make sure that those that you listen to, those that you learn from, have good spiritual eyesight. Those that have good spiritual eyesight are those who not only teach, but follow the principles of Scripture. No, whatever enters into the mouth, it eventually goes to the stomach, and it comes out in human waste. Yeah. Food never touches the heart, but what comes out of the mouth, it begins in the heart. And it's these things that defile a person.
Amen.
So if you don't want to live a polluted life, you need to guard your heart.
All right.
Because it is the wellspring of life. Of course, actions are included with words. And sometimes actions speak louder than words. Because it's how we live our lives that tells other people what we believe about God. Do you believe that Jesus is the Savior of the world? Do you believe that he died for your sins? But the good news is that he didn't stay there. No, God raised him with all power in his hand.
All power.
And he's able to change your heart on
your
today. You're
here, here.
You've got to be obedient to him.
Amen.
And follow him.
Yeah.
Is there a witness here? No, you ought to tell him thank you.
Thank you.
For dying for the sins of the world.
Here, here.
Thank you for not staying dead, but thank you, God, for raising him with all power in his hand.
My Lord.
Thank you. What comes out of the mouth
that begins
in the heart that defiles a person.
Talk to him, people.
And you'll end up with a polluted life. Somebody ought to praise God this morning.
Amen.
Somebody ought to thank you this morning. We don't have to stay in the shape that we're in. God is able to change
us.
He is. He's able to change us. And that is good news. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
The whole church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for that word. We thank God that that the word spoke to me, that I need to watch what goes in my mouth, what goes in my eye gate, my ear gate, and what comes out of my mouth. Speak life and not speak death unto ourselves today. But we thank God for the word of God, and we pray for those who are at the crossroads of your life. We pray that you will make a decision for life today. And so let us pray. And we thank you for joining us today. We pray that you were blessed by the word today. So let us pray today as we close out our service. Amen.
Amen.
Father God, as we thank you for your word, O God. We thank you, O God, that
Father, we thank you for your word. We pray that you would be with all the listeners over this broadcast today. We pray for the ones that are lost and those who need to come back home.
Yes.
Father, we pray that you would just touch their hearts and bring them back home, oh God. But oh Father, we pray peace. We pray peace that passes all understanding, oh God. We pray, oh God, that you said in your word, if we keep our minds set on thee, that you would give us that peace that passes all understanding. So thank you for your word, oh God, today. We pray that you would be with us, that we may share this word with someone who may need this word today. Thank you, oh God, for your word is